I'm still wrapping my head around this award, this icon of 2020, when I sat on the lounge and was on pause for the entire year. Incredible shock and surprise and thrilled, you know. I never really think about those things because you're working and you're not thinking about, you know, that you're an icon or anything like that. I guess I've always felt like, you know, my career has managed to keep going and I've done so many wonderful things and I don't really think about that enough. So the icon thing is funny because it just, time goes so fast. You know what I mean? But when you think about what work I've done, it's pretty remarkable. I think my favorite would be when Kate ran it. But I also think that a solo show I did, my most recent Spiegel Tent with Jethro Woodward and the Fitzroy Youth Orchestra, I think that's probably my favorite because the material I was doing was right up my alley. It was like cabaret rock, you know, heavy rock, and then, you know, a bit of Lana Del Rey and a bit of this, and it was so high energy. So I would have to say, in all honesty, that was my favorite. What I love about Adelaide Cabaret Festival is that, for me, it is the great city to put a festival on of all our cities in this country, Australia. It always has been the best city to do a festival. And for me, what I love about it is that there's a wonderful concentration and focus which other cities don't seem to be able to achieve. Gosh, what makes a Paul Capps show? That's another one I never really think about. I go with what mood I'm in at the time, what influences are happening musically, who are people or artists or politics or what's going on, and that's how I kind of throw a show together. Like the last show I did in Adelaide at the Spiegel Tent, the one I was telling you about with Jethro Woodward, I mean, that was influenced a lot by the nastiness that was going on in the world, you know, Trump and all the nastiness. And I want audiences to feel, I want them to go on a journey with emotions rather than have it, you know, be a conceptual show or a story per se, but more to do with feeling. But the thing about cabaret for me is that I feel more freedom in cabaret. I feel less restricted. You know, I can be more me in cabaret because when I play a character, I go down the rabbit hole of who that person is. If I'm playing Quentin Crisp, I want to be Quentin Crisp. I don't want to be Paul Capps at all. After the year we had, being back in front of audiences is weirdly a little scary again, like because it's been so long since we did this. So I'm excited. And I'm also nervous because I am always nervous.